And you are listening to WDRB Radio, spinning the most intergalactic hits. Wake up in the morning getting money like it's crazy. Your bitch up on my line, she likes to loot me like the Navy.
All right. Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Sneakers and Up. I am the co-host Dante, and today we have back in the building a special guest who seems to be coming back a lot, and we keep on bringing him back. Dr. B, aka Galaxy B, what is going on, fam?
What it do? You know, it's an honor to be here. You know, shout out to Big Tay, shout out to GC, shout out to the whole Sneakers and Up team. You know what I mean? It took a team to make the dream, so we here to scheme. You heard me?
There you go. So, and in case you have missed previous episodes before, Dr. B here, he's living the dream times two. So what he's doing is he is an actual performing artist, rapper, and recording. He's got videos on YouTube. Actually, the video you just saw now is his video, and then I'm gonna have the full length video at the end of it. And here's the hard one. He is a competitive professional gamer. I mean, I got the same controller. So I'm on my way.
Yep. You're on your way, man.
So real quick, before we get into any of our Sneakers and Up topics, what is that like to be a competitive gamer? I mean, it's gotta be the dream.
It's really cool. It's a blessing in disguise. 20 years in the making, you know. I graduated high school at the end of the 90s, and right after that, I was like, you know, I love gaming so much. And, you know, I used to beat everyone in high school so bad. I was like, I need a challenge. And, you know, I was just a Bay Area gamer playing. And then I met a group of other gamers who were really good. Actually, shout out to my homie Hyro, you know, Hyro Sheem Derby. And, you know, he brought me into the world of the gaming. And then we went to tournaments and stuff. And I started seeing all the top level gamers. And then eventually became one of them. You know, you just kind of rub elbows with them, play against them, and you become one. And that's kind of how it works. And your own dedication and determination really does a lot to it. Because behind the scenes, to become one of my greatest rivals competitors, I had to play on a super hard level. Like, I had to get, like, learn ins and outs and things like that. So it takes a little time. And it takes a lot of dedication and practice, for sure.
Okay. That's what's up, man. So now, it's Strike First, right?
Yes, sir. Strike First Gaming. Shout out to my team and sponsor, Cobra Kai Tone. He's the CEO. He came and found me in 2018, put me on. We 2 years in and about 8-9 medals deep, you know what I'm saying? Including 2 World Championship Evo medals. And I still hold 2 titles right now. I'm the champion of NEC. Capcom versus SNK2, that's the Philadelphia championship, and I'm also the champion of Final Round Atlanta, and I'm still holding those titles since 2019. So someone beats me, I still hold my titles. So
there we go. And Cobra, right, is helping that your title just being held longer, right?
Right. I mean, it doesn't hurt. You know, I can talk about it for a minute until we get back to it. You know, I'm ready to defend it, and I'm ready to play. You know, I just miss fighting and playing. You know, that's what this whole COVID and quarantine thing has kind of dampened, being on tour and everything. That's what I'd be doing right now, besides chilling with you. And even if I was on tour, I'd probably be here with you. But still, I'd just rather be on tour here with you. So
facts.
And it's fun. I actually did my first world tour with Strike First Gaming in 2019. And we traveled the world. We went all over the U.S. We went to Japan, and that was great. And I've just learned a lot and just keep on stacking up experience and finding new rivals and getting new challenges. And you never really are the best. There's just always someone who could teach you a new lesson and teach you something. It's just like martial arts and real fighting. So,
right. So real quick, before we break off and start getting into it, I got to bring up that I got a minor beef with you, sir.
Okay.
So I saw your music videos, and I see you overseas.
Right.
You know, you have sneaker shops in your background, and I have not received one call about, yo, this, we got this out here. I'm just messing with you.
That's fair. You know,
it's all good. I had to put you on Front Street for that one.
You know what's so funny? Now and then, when I'm in the middle of the moment, I'm just caught up in the shopping and the razzle dazz.
No, I feel it.
But you know what I was always remembering people on was just clothes. I would just buy hella extra hat snapbacks and like, you know, like coasters for the room and like keychains and stuff. So that's stuff that I picked up for people. And I do got something for you, brother. So it's never too late. It's never too late. A whole list of stuff that I got from Japan. And I got a little something for you, you know what I mean? Because you guys have always been so nice to me on the show. So I got you, player.
Bet I appreciate that. Thank you. I mean, just for you and anybody else, nothing is ever needed. We just, I mean, we do this for fun. We don't do this for money.
Oh yeah, of course.
It's just for the love. Just for the love.
Yeah. But I got a little something for the shores of Japan to celebrate with, and you ask and you shall receive. That's what the Lord said. So.
Right. So I'm okay. Well, then this day forward, I'm gonna ask every time.
Yeah, it never hurts.
All right, so. Now we get back into the scheme of things. So, so first and foremost, we always start off with what you rocking, what you watching. Right. So, sir, what you rocking, what you watching?
So, what I'm rocking right now is them good old fashioned, you know, all black Yeezy 350s. Like I always got those on. So, the 350 Yeezy all blacks, got those banging. I definitely have a variety of the Reebok Ice Cream Classics, you know, the old school ones that came out back in the early 2000s. I got those in rotation. Always keep a pair of Air Jordan 1s. Gotta get those in rotation. Those are just like staple must-haves. In between that, I just been like mainly in Yeezys. Like I just like throwing them on. So I wear a lot of my 350 Yeezys. And yeah, those are kind of it right now. I got some Pharrell slides recently and those are dope. And I just throw those on for like walking around the house or just like to the store and stuff. And so shout out to Pharrell, Star Trek, you dig? So
I feel it. I feel it. Okay. And then what you watching? Anything you watching? Any movies or TV shows or anything you've been trying to catch up on or something new that you've seen recent?
You know what I've been watching is Barbarians on Netflix. And if you haven't watched it yet, it's great. It's a story about when the Roman Empire invaded Germania. And what people don't know Germania is it's old school Germany, of course, what it sounds like, but it's all the surrounding territory. Like there were so many other parts of Belgium, Germany, all this stuff, and it was called once Germania. And all the people in Germania were called barbarians by the Roman Empire because they were the powerhouse like that was ruling the world at the time and conquering everywhere. And it's a story about how the Germanians, aka the barbarians or what have you, rose up against the Roman Empire. And that's all I want to say is how they rise up. And it's like a revolt. And it's really good. And it's actually historically correct and has a lot of reference to real people and stuff. They just kind of add their own script and story to it. But it's really good. And it gives like a real Braveheart type of feel in a show. So check that out.
Okay. I'm going to have to check it out then. Because I mean, we spoke on it time and time again on this, whether it's the podcast or YouTube. Netflix is on point when it comes to their movies and shows. I'll get to mine in just a second. Are you watching anything else or is that it?
So I watched Barbarians. That's tight. I, of course, watched Cobra Kai, like still getting ready for Cobra Kai season 3 in January.
Oh, that's soon, huh?
Yeah, it's coming up in January. And then what I've been watching right now as well is The Mandalorian's back. So everyone
Don't say nothing.
Oh, of course not. Of course not. Never would.
I haven't seen it yet.
I'm a hardcore Star Wars fan and theorist and supporter and philosopher, so I would never dare spoil anything. But the new Mandalorian season's finna be lit. Like, let me tell you, because if you like the first season, it's like, wow, this new one is just like picks right up from where it left off. So it's gonna be
the first season is dope.
Yeah. Season 2 is gonna be way more intense. That's all I can tell the fans. It's way more intense. And I think that they're giving the fans more of what they want. They listen to fan feedback. They listen to fan input. And when the creators of Star Wars do that, it just does amazing things for people. So I'm glad that they have the right people behind it.
Well, I assume this year the budget was bigger.
Well, yeah, I would think so. They got a lot of money out of the first season. So
probably a lot more than they expected, because I know it was kind of a test because people know of what a Mandalorian is. But I think that Baby Yoda really drove everyone. Yeah, there it is. Baby Yoda drove everyone to the Mandalorian and then just realized how much of the Mandalorian they actually liked.
Right. So, you know, shout out to Baby Yoda. I'm a fan, obviously.
I almost bought a Funko for my son. It's Baby Yoda, but it has a frog. Like he was eating a frog.
Oh, yeah. Nice. That's a good one. That's actually the exclusive one. I got one behind me with him with the cup.
So, okay. Oh, yeah. Damn, if I known it was exclusive, I just thought it was a regular Funko Pop.
Yeah, I mean, but they're different tiers. Some of them are more rare than others. Yeah.
Okay, I feel it.
Yeah.
All right. So for me, we are recording. I'm depending on how fast I can get this YouTube video edited slash podcast put up. We are recording on Halloween Day, and we will speak to that a little later. So if you're watching YouTube, I got the gray, black, and orange hat. But earlier today, I was rocking the Reebok Question Low orange toe.
I like those. They're white and orange toe.
Yep.
Yeah.
So I was rocking those earlier. Today is the last day of Boktober, so I've been rocking Reeboks. Whether I had a chance to post them or not, I've been rocking them all month. So wow. I got enough for every day of the month, so I've been rocking them all.
That's what's up.
So that's what I'm rocking. What I'm watching is another Netflix show, Blood of Zeus. It's an anime. I've never watched an anime before.
Wow, I'm gonna watch that today. Like
it is pretty good. Okay. I mean, I may have to look into some more anime stuff. I mean, I was pretty impressed with the storyline. I mean, obviously, I think the anime, as far as the animation goes, it looks like anime to me. I mean, as far as like what it's supposed to be, I guess it's my first anime. This is my introduction to anime. So I was pretty impressed with it. I just got done rewatching all 6 Alien movies.
Okay.
So between last weekend and this weekend, I've watched all 6.
Mm-hmm.
I had no idea there was 6. I thought there was 3.
Oh, wow. Yeah. There's the, there's Aliens versus Predators as well.
Right. And I was loaned those as well. So he gave me, I think there's like 3 or 4 of them. So I got all those.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't know that there were 2 prequels and then 4 Alien movies all in sequence.
Right.
So I completely threw me off. And I just got done watching the last one last night. Mm-hmm. So I just got done rewatching those. So that's what I've been watching.
Nice, nice. And big suggestion on anime, you got to watch Demon Slayer. And you got to watch it in Japanese with the subtitles. Every anime you watch, watch it in Japanese with the subtitles. That's the real feeling. You can't be lazy. You just got to read it out and like feel what they're saying. And because when you don't get the pure feeling of the soul of the people and culture. You're just getting it watered down American version, how they're saying
that's
it.
That's true. Okay, it's fair enough.
You got to read it and watch it. That's the key to anime. Don't watch an American dub. You got to watch it in Japanese so you hear the passion and what they're saying and doing, even if you don't understand it, you're reading what they're saying. And that helps your mind too, because reading's fundamental. So
that is true.
So, so check out Demon Slayer. That's one. You definitely got to go back and watch Dragon Ball Z, the most world famous anime of all time, you know, and there's another one that's new called My Hero Academia. So you got to check those out.
I mean, is there like one Dragon Ball Z I know there's like a bunch of them.
Dragon Ball is the original series, which was really old school, and then it goes into Dragon Ball Z and then into Dragon Ball Super, which is present day version. But what you'd have to start watching, and I suggest start watching, is Dragon Ball Z. Just starting from Dragon Ball is kind of redundant. You can like maybe do that later, but what's important is Dragon Ball Z. So the first episode of Dragon Ball Z all the way to Dragon Ball GT. Now GT is a series that happens after Z, but before Dragon Ball Super, which is present day. So basically what happened is they have Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Ball GT, and now Dragon Ball Super. But Dragon Ball GT is now deemed as an uncanon reality, which a lot of fans are upset with. They kind of did a Star Wars thing, how they did a lot of the lore. They made it uncanon. They did the same thing in Marvel and stuff. They did the same thing. They kind of made GT, which in the hearts and the fans of many anime lovers is the best, you know, or one of their favorite arcs in the story, is now uncanon and now just like lore and stuff like that. So I just say Dragon Ball Z and then Super, so you can keep the continuity. And then you can go watch GT and get a different appreciation to see what happened really after Z.
Okay. All right. Well, I know Dragon Ball Z, that's got a lot. And I've never really been into it before. So what I'll try to do is, being that this was only my first one, but it had to do a lot with Greek mythology. And I'm really big into Greek mythology, that blood of Zeus.
I do, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that's the reason why I even watched it. So I'll have to check out Demon Slayer.
And that's a great one to watch with, like, yeah, that one's great. Demon Slayer, I would say, you know, how old your kid?
He's quite a way away. So
I don't know how old. Okay, but like, how old is he?
7.
7. Okay, yeah. So I'm just saying, for all the viewers out there, I would suggest Demon Slayer. Maybe watch that one with kids, like maybe 10 or up. But it's no nudity or anything, but it's just a little more violent. But Dragon Ball Z, you can watch with a kid 7 and up. It's acceptable. And it's so good that even if you're an adult, you like it. You're like, this is dope. It's just
okay.
The fighting, the storyline, everything. The villains, the whole arc of everything is great. So check that out.
Okay, I'll give it a shot.
Yep.
I'll give it a shot.
I got the links for you, so don't worry. I'll send you the links so you can see it all free and stream it.
Perfect. Oh, wow. Yeah. That's always appreciated. That makes it a lot easier to watch.
Yeah, definitely.
All right. So if we keep on going, next topic we're going to cover, and here on YouTube, we're going to have the images up. So we'll go over Heat, Sleep, and Nah. And then after we go over the ones, the images, then we'll go over, I know you brought some to the table.
Yes, I did. I brought a few special sneakers because this is Halloween edition of Sneakers and Up. I brought a couple special shoes, actually a few special shoes and one special mystery clothing item to show today. So we'll get into that. So you got to stay tuned to see that. So
there you go. Perfect.
Stay tuned for that one.
All right. So first one we're going to bring up for Heat, Sleep, and Nah is, and then you can just give your opinion on it. Heat, Sleep, and Nah. If you want to discuss anything further, you can. But just for everybody listening or watching, basically Heat is dope. We want it. We like it. Sleep, not so much. If someone gave it to me, I wouldn't throw it away, basically.
Right.
And then Nah is absolute trash. Get it out of here.
Right.
All right. So the first one is going to be the Reebok Question Low BBC collab Running Dog.
Yes. I'm here for it.
So that's a Heat for you.
That's Heat rocks. Like, how are you going to take one of the hottest sneakers of all time, which is the Iverson, and the hottest Reebok, definitely hands down, from Iverson, and then collab it with Billionaire Boys Club and Ice Cream? I mean, and the box is like, it's insane. And then you got, you know, Iverson on the cone with the braids on it, and that's the keychain that it comes with too. It's fire. Like, no one sees that a lot, but the keychain has the little braids on it too. It's exclusive.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that one.
Yeah, and for all the viewers out there who just saw it, you know what I mean, it has that yellow and that purple with the other purple, the, you know, lighter purple and white, and the Hexalite technology, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just love those Reebok Iversons. So to see those, and they're one of the rarest shoes. So let's get into it for a second. Recently, I just got the Billionaire Boys Club and Ice Cream beepers and butts and the name chains, and they sold out in seconds. Like, literally, I was there. I clicked them into the cart. I came back, I hit refresh, and every size was gone, literally in like 30 seconds.
And these are also Reebok Question Lows for everyone else listening.
Yes, Reebok Question Lows. So if you want to look them up, and you know, we got the images for y'all, the Reebok Question Low beepers and butts, and also the Reebok Question Low name chains. Their collabos with Ice Cream and Billionaire Boys Club sold out in seconds. Obviously one of the rare shoes on earth now.
I didn't even know that they were dropping.
Yeah, you can't get them nowhere. Like, you can get them on StockX and stuff, but like, they didn't even sell them on Reebok. They only sold through Billionaire Boys Club. Like, it's so exclusive, and so will these. So, you know, keep your eyes out, and good luck to everyone trying to get them.
No. You know what? I'm going to post this video after these come out. All right. So now my verdict, these are Heat all the way. These are nasty. Right. I got to have these. And that material looks crazy smooth.
It does.
That material looks crazy smooth. But you touched on everything else, so I'll leave that one. We can move on to the next. But those, if we had a verdict higher than Heat, it would be higher than Heat. Those are dope. All right. So the next one, and you can give any specific one you want, or you can give it as a whole, is going to be the New Balance Jolly Rancher pack, basically. Right. And it comes with the New Balance 327 Kawhi. And I don't remember if the Kawhi shoe is two different shoes put together, like two different mismatch, or if it's two separate pairs. There's also a New Balance, kind of like an old school looking sneaker, like almost like a court classic low kind of thing, and then a slide.
Right, yeah.
So what's your verdict on either the pack or in general?
I think that for me, that's a nah. They're just not my style of shoe, and the colorways just weren't that appealing to me. Except that, you know, the Kawhi shoe looks kind of like the Lego Adidas collabo that just dropped.
It does.
Kind of has the same colorway. So For me, I don't know. And like New Balance for me, I have to be the classic old school grandpa runners. Like if I don't wear those, I ain't wearing them. Like I only want the classic New Balance in on the side, suede, look like the Juvenile Hall shoe. Like that's the one I want. Like I'm not going to really wear any of their other signature shoes. Just not for me, but I can't knock anyone who wears them, right? I've seen people pull them off. But when you talk about shoes and the shoe hierarchy and what's hot and what's not in today's modern hip hop culture or just culture period, you're not talking about New Balance these days. You're talking about Adidas, you're talking about Nike, Jordan, of course, and you're talking about Reeboks, of course, and that's where it is. And then you have, you know, your designer shoes, like, you know, your Louis, your Gucci's and all that stuff, but that's about it. That's like what's hot and Off-White, of course, so.
Right. The only time they get talking about only rapper that's talking about New Balance is, give me 1 second, I did my research. It is, I think, what is it? Jack Harlow.
Jack Harlow, yep.
He was signed to New Balance.
Yep, he did, yeah. And you know, a big ups to him. You know, I'm not the hugest Jack Harlow fan personally, but I don't knock anybody who has a hustle and does what they do. He's a young man doing his thing. So I even if I'm not the biggest Jack Harlow fan, I support the fact that he got a signed shoe and he's right. doing his thing. And he's a young man doing his thing. So, you know, shout out to Jack Harlow off top. You know, no hate over here. Everyone does doing their thing, do your thing. That's what I'm about. So
you're right. I'm just putting it out there. I didn't know if anybody else knew that or not. But yeah, he signed a New Balance, which is crazy because I've never known a rapper to be signed a New Balance.
Mm-hmm.
I know they've done a couple collabs, but from what I understand, he's signed, he's getting checks.
Mm-hmm.
So for my personal opinion for the New Balance Jolly Rancher pack, I attempted to cop today, obviously not retail. I always pay below retail, otherwise I'm passing. But is the New Balance 327. I think those, as far as the picture goes, are fire. The rest of them are not.
Mm. I don't like the rest of them. Is that the one that's the kind of like
all blue with like a shoe? Say it again.
Looks like a Steph Curry shoe. It's kind of all blue with the like yellow liner.
No, it's the all blue with like the neon green sole. It's low top. Oh,
got it. Yep, I seen them.
Yeah, it's almost like an old school kind of old school runner.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been really getting into New Balances a lot lately, and basically it's been like the 997s. I might venture off and buy my first 990, but I wanted to try these 327s. Good thing with newbalance.com is if you don't like it, you can send it back.
That's lit. A lot of other places give you trouble about that.
Man, facts. So, all right. So that was my verdict, was the 327 was heat and the rest of them, nah.
Right.
So the next one is going to be the New Balance 992 Concepts Pack. Now, there's two of them.
Right.
What are your thoughts on those?
The 997 Concepts Pack.
992.
That's the one that has 992. So that's the one that has the two images mirrored.
Yes, and there's two of them.
Mm-hmm. I kind of like the one that looks like Barney. It's like it looks like kind of more like teal and purple. That one looks kind of cool. I would wear those for like hiking and running and stuff like that. I wouldn't wear them for like a fit flex, but okay. I would wear them for the purpose of like working out or running or something. They're like cool. But still, again, if I was going to wear a shoe, it's probably going to be Adidas, Nike, or Reebok. If I'm going to be in the gym. Now, right. Let's just say I'm going out to a national park or I'm going somewhere where my ass might die at. I might throw these on to make sure that the
protection. You said where my ass might die.
Right. Because, you know, those shoes are really the performance-based. They may not be the most stylish, but you know what? I give New Balance performance credit. They outperform when it comes to being like particularly for hiking, particularly for terrain. You know, like that's what those are good for, I feel.
Yeah, no, facts. So so the other one would be a nah then?
The other one would be a nah. So that the first color, yeah, the other one would be a nah for me. It just doesn't appeal to me as much. But like I said, it's different strokes for different folks, and different people have different tastes on that one.
No,
how do you feel on your one?
Me, I think they're both heat.
Mm.
I want them both. Will I buy them both? Nah. I probably, for multiple reasons. One, I probably think the retail is probably going to be too high to justify buying two. Right. Second off, I wouldn't wear both enough to justify paying them.
Okay, makes sense.
So that's So that's. To me, I like the kind of how you're going. I do like the teal and purple one. I do like that one a lot better. Mm-hmm. That one I feel like you can pull off year round. The other one I feel like is more of like a fall kind of winter.
Yeah,
See, fair. And I do wear these for I do wear New Balances and whatnot for like casual wear.
Mm-hmm.
Not, you know, when the world is ending.
Right. But see, also, see, what everyone else doesn't know is you have so many other power shoes in your flex, you can just throw these on to give them a break because you really have so many exclusives. And like, without, I can brag for you. I know what you've been up to all these years. We started off being friends and you know, working together in the shoe business, and then, right, you know, and being collectors from that point on, and being in the management of that even. So we have some hidden gems that if we want to ruin someone's day, we could throw them on.
Yeah, I mean, it's facts. That, yeah. I do have to admit, though, that I saw a bunch of opportunity to get rid of the stuff that I had no business wearing. You know what I mean? I'm not in the same kind of avenue that you are, as far as, you know, I work a regular 9-to-5. I work with a bunch of people who don't care nothing about sneakers. Where right. I live, I left the Bay Area. I'm now somewhere else. I mean, I tried wearing them once or twice. Nobody ever noticed. I mean, I liked them for me, but I can't walk around in, you know, $2,500 sneakers when I'm like, I could sell them,
mm-hmm,
and, you know, buy more sneakers that I can just beat up.
Right. And that makes sense. That's
so typically that's what I did. I got a few. I got some Travis Scott's and I got a couple other things, but you know, I'm this close. I'm trying to buy them Guava Unions. Everyone does not like them. And I actually like them a lot. So those are on my radar. So, but yeah, so anyway, so I got rid of a lot of stuff,
mm-hmm,
but to move on before we get too crazy with the tangent,
right.
The next one is going to be the Jordan 1 High Zoom Comfort, mm-hmm, Zion Williamson.
Right.
What are you feeling about those?
Those are fire. Like, I love those. I like that purple. And I like that mid panel. It looks like it's like a kind of like material. It looks like the material is a little different, kind of like a gray webby looking material.
It looks like denim.
Denim. Okay. It looks like denim.
Like a stonewashed black denim.
Yeah. Those are fire. Those, I mean, those are just sick. I mean, a lot of people don't wear purple like that, but that's a shoe that'll make you wear purple.
Like, I love purple.
Right. I'm a color spectrum person. I believe that life's too short to be bland. You got to use color. Color is a blessing. And little quick, like side tangent, you know, back in ancient times, if you wore color, you were royal. Like, you couldn't even wear certain colors unless you were royalty. Purple being one of them, red, certain stuff. Only the royals can wear them. Only the royals can wear them. So, you know, in honor of the ancient times, I'm staying royal. You see, I'm in some red right now, you know, and I'm in some purple, some teal, some green, whatever I feel. It's like, don't be bland in life. But some people just like more subtleness, and they just like, you know, the earth tones and black and gray. But in my opinion, I feel it gets boring after a while. And I was a person who only stuck to like a main color palette when I was in high school. And then eventually I was like, you know what? Let me start wearing more of the crazy, wilder colors, because like, I have so many crazy shoes that are like it, but I'm just trying to match like one color on the shoe, the main color that I can get away with, that, you know, da da da. And I was just like, nah, I'm just gonna go crazy. And that's, ever since then, I just got a crazy style palette.
I feel it. No, I'm 100% with you. So for these to me are a sleep. I'll try for them because they are purple.
Right.
That's the only reason why I'm gonna try for them, is because they're purple. I love purple.
Right.
If I don't hit, you know, it is what it is. I'll just move on. I won't try and get them for resale. I won't try and chase them down. Right now, I'm catching a lot of L's from Sneakers app.
Mm-hmm.
A lot. By the way, folks, PSA, don't return nothing to Nike. You return to Nike, they're going to block you on the Sneakers app.
Wow.
So they'll admit all day long, but I went through a long stretch of scoring, hitting. And then I started buying technical stuff because I wanted to try out technical stuff. And Nike has fallen really short on technical sneakers.
Mm-hmm.
The comfort isn't there. I'm going to Reebok for the Zig Kineticas. I'm going to New Balance for the 992s or 990s because they're comfortable. Nike, you've fallen fast, man. Y'all better step your game up, try and be competitive again. And by the way, folks, we are not getting paid from anyone. I just don't really care for Nike's performance sneakers anymore.
Right. So
I bought them to give them a try them out, and didn't like them. So I returned them. Well, since I started returning stuff, they have been like, for example, the you know how the Fire Red Force came back out on the shock drop?
Mm-hmm.
I was at my phone and I got the notification from J23 app. As soon as I saw it, I went right in, and I had to be one. I had to be one of the very first 9.5s to get in there. I was that quick on it. Mm-hmm. And I had the iPhone, so it was the Face ID. And it sat forever and just spun and spun and spun. And it sat for about 4 to 5 minutes, which on the sneakers app is a lifetime.
Right.
And then it told me sold out. I was on my phone. I was on my phone when the shock drop happened.
Yeah, I mean, I was up this morning to get the Travis, the Travis Knotts, aka the Moco Air Jordan 1. And it just didn't, it had it in the cart, and then every website crapped out. I was like, what's going on? So, and including my sneakers app, I had it in there. It said, loading, or, it was like scrolling. Right. And then you didn't get your size. So I was like, what? And then it happened on like three other sites. Like, I had one in the cart. I had like the shoe, clicking on it, and then it crapped out. Like, so people, Nike, get it together.
Make more pairs. Yo, whack.
Oh no.
The I have the Travis Scott ones. So wow. I have those. So I tried for these this morning for resale. Basically, I'm just gonna put it out there. I tried for resale. That's why I'm not mad that I didn't hit. Right. So I tried for resale because I knew there would be something. If everybody else is reselling, why not, right?
Right.
But yeah, same thing, I didn't hit.
Mm.
So yep. But for these are asleep. These are asleep for me. So the next one we're gonna get on is going to be the Jordan 3 Court Purple. Now, hold on. Before you say anything, I need to say this because these are three, and they're purple. These are a nasty heat. Absolute nasty. I need to have them. If you got a plug, don't admit it on here, but I need your help to get these because these are Asia exclusive. These are not coming out in the States.
Okay. I didn't even know. Oh, they're not coming out in the States.
They are not coming out in the States. I've saw it on every post so far that I've seen. They are Asia only. Not even Europe. Asia.
Okay.
So
it can be done.
These are... Shh. Don't tell nobody.
Right.
These are absolute fire to me. I'm a little slightly upset that they have the orange on there. I wish they would have just left it like where the orange is, put it gray or something.
Right.
But I'll do that myself. I don't care. Right. I want these. These are insane to me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now your opinion.
And after that, how can you not want them? No, I'm just playing. I'm going to have to say these are asleep because I'm not a huge 3 fan, but I like the colorway of this. And, of course, any of the elephant print, cement print are always a classic. So I cannot deny that this is not going to be one of the hottest shoe releases or that it's fire. It's just not my personal fire because I'm not a 3 word, but I definitely would resell these like a mother. I would resell these like a mother because everyone they mama wants them. And you just said that they're Asia only. It would make the demand for them insanity.
Yep. To me, these are absolute fire. And the fact that they were supposed to come out, then they canceled it. And then they were supposed to come out and they canceled again. And now they're releasing them, but only in Europe or Asia.
Right. That's just insane.
So I have the yellow ones, the white and yellow threes, the women's ones. Mm-hmm. I have those. And I actually want to get a second pair to paint the yellow orange.
Oh, okay.
To paint the yellow purple.
That'd be dope. You should.
Yeah. Cause I mean, the only way for me to get that actual sneaker is to pay, I think it's like $30,000 for the actual Kobe white and purple threes.
Nah,
not doing it. I think that's not doing it.
Mm-mm.
All right, so that was all we had for the images that are posted up on YouTube. Now it's time for filter off, sir. What you got for heat sleeping on? What you bringing?
What am I bringing? Okay, so filter off. We about to get this popping, y'all. So back to the layer. You know what I'm saying? And we're gonna get into 3 pairs of my favorite kicks that I just recently copped. So
these are a heat sleeper not for me, right?
Right.
So you bought them, so you already think the heat.
So, I already think the heat. So this is heat sleeper not for you. First up, we're going to do, and here's the box. Ooh, look at that. Nice box. Adidas Star Wars collabo, right?
Okay.
So we're going to get into this. So Opening the box, and ooh, what's in there? It ain't nothing but gold, baby. The C-3PO Adidas Top 10 High.
All gold everything.
Yeah, all gold everything. So, you know, check it out. On the tongue, we got C-3PO right there.
That's dope.
The stitching is back. On the back, we got C-3PO.
That's dope, too.
I'm sorry. These are pure magma. If you were lucky enough to get a pair, gold on everything. These are busts, so... You know, give y'all a different angle of them, but they're really sick. I love this shit.
So it says star on one sneaker and wars on the other?
Yes. Star on one sneaker, wars on the other. And it comes with interlace locks that say C-3PO and different little saying. It comes with a bag full of them. You have like a whole bunch of different lace
Holy
locks.
Holy crap.
So guess what? I'm taking some of those lace locks and putting them on other Adidas that I got.
Yeah.
That why, not? Around. Why not? Why
That's not? Dope.
Yeah. So it gives you a chance to sprucing up some of your other shoes too. So Dante, with that being said, is that a heat sleeper not for you?
Okay, so I got a lot of things to contribute here. So I'm not a big fan of gold.
Right.
So I can't give it a heat. I'm going to have to give it a sleep, but the details are crazy. Right. The attention to detail. Let me ask this. Okay, here's my defining question.
Right.
What's on the insole? Is it a plain insole? I mean, I know no one ever sees the insole.
Hey, never that. Never that. So we're going to go ahead and get into what the insole is. The insole.
If it's a dope insole, then
I'm going to go ahead and pull it out for you.
Don't tear up the cushion if that's the case.
Oh, I didn't. The insole is a special Star Wars insole.
Okay.
And it has imagery of, this is like imagery of C-3PO. It's split between the two.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. The detail is crazy. So I'm going to give it a heat, but I'm going to give it a not me wearing heat.
Right.
Pulling off an all gold sneaker. Like I can do all black with like hints of gold or all something with hints of gold, but I can't do all gold. So right. I'm gonna give that a heat, but not me rocking it.
Okay, that's fair enough. So check this out. We're gonna get into the next one.
Okay.
So again, Star Wars Adidas collabo.
Let's keep it going.
We're gonna keep this going because this is Halloween. Big shout out to everyone on Halloween edition.
There you go.
Our sneakers and up. So we're gonna move into You heard it. You love them. Some people like to hate them. But first, may the force be with you, everyone. May
the there force you go.
That's on the side of every box of the Star Wars collabo. Just letting you know, when you open it up on the side, it has that.
Oh, it's a box, like a pull-out box within the box?
Pull-out box, yes.
Okay, okay.
So when you open them, boom.
Like a drawer, okay.
Yeah, it's like a drawer. So we're going to start the music. Dun, 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 dun. These are the Darth Vader superstars.
Wow, what are those lines like going down?
Those lines are like how Vader's.
That's what I thought it was. Oh,
it's so serious. But let's get into the details. Lord Vader is right there on the tongue.
Okay, is that like the Obama sign where it has like one color on one side and one on the other?
Yeah, it's like that. They did it in that style art. Darth Vader there. Biggest detail, Darth Vader on the toe box.
What?
Darth Vader on both sides of the toe box.
I don't know if I like that or if it's ugly. I don't know. I'm on the fence.
It's fire. Backside right there.
I like it. Tell me now, dude. It's fire.
Hey, sorry. On the bottom, your father. I am your father right there.
Other way.
Fire. This fire comes with a bag of lace locks as well. That say Vader and Star Wars and stuff on the lace locks, and it comes with a bag full of them. So these are complete magma.
You know what, that's gonna be another one. I'm not real big on the superstars. I'm still on the fence with the actual Vader being on the toe, but the details are crazy. That mold has got to be dope, like on the toe itself.
It is. It's raised and everything.
I'm going to have to give that another one, a heat that I wouldn't wear.
Right.
That's
right.
Dope, though. That's dope.
It's for every Star Wars fan and collector out there, for sure.
That's dope.
And the last one we're going to get into. So I would first like to start with, I got this in honor of the grandfather that I never had, the first black man in space, the first black superhero before there was Black Panther, before there was Blade, before there was anyone like that, there was Lando Calrissian, Mr. Billy D. Williams. So shout out to Mr. Billy D. Williams. And he's been real nice. So whenever I post him in post of like old retro pictures, or when I got these shoes, he reposted on his actual Instagram. So and I have screenshots of that. Yeah, I have screenshots. Yeah, he has reposted me several times. And big shout out to Mr. Williams. And I've actually had some, you know, I DM'd him and stuff, and like, and he read my comments and everything, and he replied, and he's really nice. And he just, yeah, it's amazing. And he's reposted me several times. So big shout out to Billy D. Williams, the living legend. And we're going to get into the Lando Calrissian.
That's the best box so far.
Star Wars NMDs. And we're going to get into this real quick. So,
do they all have the picture like that?
No.
That's the best box so far.
Only Boba Fett, Chewbacca, Lando, and Han Solo, they have the graphics. Only certain heroes have the graphics, and then certain heroes don't.
Okay.
So, and villains.
Right.
So let's get into it. The Lando Calrissian NMDs. And these are sick. Details are dope. It has Lando Calrissian's face right here. Let me clear that. Sorry, let me get right here. Boom, Lando Calrissian.
Okay.
Real futuristic look to him.
Yeah. The lace kind of cover, does that come off?
Oh, no. That's just a part of it. It's a part of it. The lace is, it's like a lace cover that's just on it. It's stitched in. It makes them different than the other NMDs. The other NMDs are very different. And the insole is cool because it has like a special insole as well. Everyone has the Star Wars special colored insole and stuff. Like you can see kind of like space print in there, like a nebula.
Are those gold aglets too?
Gold aglets on the tip.
Oh.
And they actually say Lando Calrissian up on them really close. Fire. And if you look at them together, minus the accessory bag.
Okay, here's my verdict. Heat that I would wear.
Right.
Those Heat, are dope.
These are dope. These are dope. Hey, I showed them to one of my best friends who's a shoe collector, and he said, B, where's the link to those? Can you still get those? Is what he said. And I was like, man.
What was your answer?
Like, no, they're gone. It's like these are gone real quick. I think in your size, I can still track them down, and they'll be about under 200 on retail.
Nah, I can't do it.
Yeah, too expensive.
Well, it's not necessarily the price, it's the timing.
Yeah. You got other things going on, and you got other drops coming. Other drops are coming.
Other drop. Yeah, just got a bunch of things, but damn, those are dope though.
Yep. So the last thing I got over here, we're going to get into my last special Halloween special item, which is the Billionaire Boys Club Ice Cream Mummies Cones and Bones Tea. That's glow in the dark. It's the cherry eyes. And then we'll take it out in a second. Ice cream. If you look up close, that's a flagship exclusive.
Where's the flagship?
Flagship is in New York.
Okay, just for everyone not knowing, I didn't know either.
Yeah, the New York store is the flagship.
Okay.
So there you go. And then I'll go ahead and show everyone how that looks. Check it out. The cones and bones with the mummy ice cream tea.
And that is glow in the dark?
That is glow in the dark.
Okay, I kind of like that. I think that's a heat. That's something I would wear. That's a heat.
Right.
I like how it has the cherries even on the skull.
Right. The cherries even on the back. Yeah.
Yeah, that's dope.
On the back. Yeah. It's sick. And I like it. I have the flagship exclusive tag on it and everything. It's pretty sick.
Okay. I'm not a huge BBC fan, but that's dope. I like that one.
Thank you.
That's dope. Okay. That's a heat as well.
Right. I'm throwing that on today for Halloween. You know what I mean? Shout out to Halloween Quarantine 2020, y'all. You know?
Perfect. It fits. Back. Right. Now we're going to go over the topics of discussion today. So the first we're going to go over is one. Actually, these are the topics that you brought up. So we're going to go over, are Yeezys still hot? So do you have an argument that you want to put up, or are you asking my opinion? Well, what are you thinking for this one? What are we looking for?
So are Yeezys still hot in this modern era and right now, or are they dying down? So that was why I want to ask you, and then I have a whole insight to that because I'm still a big Yeezy purchaser and what have you. So,
okay,
do you feel that Yeezys still have the flame on the hype and, you know, the resale value? And do you think that everyone's still on them like how they were originally? Do you think you've seen a decline, or do you think it's staying stable?
So I have to give my, I do have already my biased opinion about them. I don't like Yeezys as a whole.
Mm-hmm.
Just for what they are, I don't feel that the Yeezy 350 is like the most popular one. Mm-hmm. I don't feel that justifies, what is it, $250?
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel that it justifies
220 plus, you know, so shipping, right? $250. Yeah.
So I don't feel that that is a justifiable price for that sneaker. It probably costs them, I don't know, $7-$8 to make.
Right.
Now the 700s are the only ones that I'm a fan of,
mm-hmm,
in general.
Right.
The rest of them, I really don't care for.
Right, right.
I mean, as much say as I'm almost anti Yeezy footwear.
Right.
So it's kind of, I kind of have a biased opinion. Now, if I take a look at it as a whole, where I'm actually like, okay, well, here's my personal view. Boom.
Right.
I think that he needs to start doing something different. I think there's still that everybody still wants it. He's making it, I think it's a little bit more available. It's, mm-hmm, still selling. Mm-hmm. But I mean, I think it's going to a specific demographic, which is not necessarily hood anymore. Mm-hmm. I think these are more toward like the Beverly Hills type people.
Right.
And I'm not talking about like a color or anything. I'm talking mindset.
Right, right, right.
So, and that's what I think. So I don't know if it's on a decline or an incline. I do think that he's potentially, I figured out a way to make them cheaper, mm-hmm, to where he can still, or how to sell them, or how to make his profit more, is basically what I'm saying.
Right.
So that's what I think. I think that they're still moving. I think they're at a steady pace.
Yeah. And I would agree. I think that Yeezy is still very hot based on the shoe. So, you know, 350 still have a lot of hype. I mean, they sell out in minutes. They sell out in seconds. I mean, they still have the hype. If they didn't, they sit on the shelf an hour after or not. But you, right, don't see them around an hour after. They're gone. So they're still in high demand. But the hotness depends on the shoe. So, like, I agree with you. 700 V3s, particularly 700 V3s, any color are super sick. Like, right when I seen, like, the first colors of them and stuff, I was like, oh, my God, these look like alien shoes. You know, like, they look crazy.
Yep.
My favorite model still is the 350, but next to that is the 380s. So I have, okay, the 380 Peppers, and I just copped the Calcite Glow. Those just came out this morning. So I grabbed those two pairs of Calcite Glow. And those are like his first 380 that glows in the dark. So that,
okay,
that's pretty sick. Yeah. So I'm looking forward to rocking those and getting those. Those are exclusive. So
see, I have four pair of Yeezys total. And they're all 700s. I have three pair of the 700 V1s, and then I have one pair of the V3s.
Nice.
Yeah.
Wow, nice. That's dope.
So I have the first colorway of the V3s.
Oh, those are valuable.
The kind of like off-white and black?
Yeah, those are sick. Those are worth a lot of money, too. Those are nice. I wanted those.
Really?
Yeah, those hold some value, brother.
I've worn them a couple of times.
And they're grailed. So. And they're grails. Those are grails. When you throw those on, people are like, they know what's up. They won't say nothing, but they're like this. Oh, shit.
Yeah. That's crazy coming, because I don't care for the Yeezys. I just like that shoe. Because, I mean, yeah, and we said it on this podcast, YouTube, on this show, numerous times, we buy what we like.
Right.
So, and I just happen to like those. And I was able to get them for retail. So, I was like, all right, cool. You know, let's do it.
Man, you're lucky on that one. The next other Yeezy that I really like is the 500s. So I always suggest get one pair of 500s. They're really nice. They're the ones that kind of look like New Balance-y with the little alien pods on the bottom.
Oh, I had two colorways and I didn't like them.
Right.
They were comfortable though.
Right.
Arguably, to me, they were more comfortable than the 350s. Mm. Arguably. I think they were more comfortable.
They're really comfortable. Not to, yeah, say, I was just telling my producer, Cosflow, shout out to Kazi, you know, I mean, on Instagram, like I was like, bro, you got to get a pair of 500s because he has Yeezy slides, Yeezy 350s, he has Yeezy 380s. And I was like, you got to get a pair of 500s. And he's like, oh, when those utility blacks come out, I'm getting them. I was like, yeah.
Those are one of the ones I had.
Yeah, yeah, they're coming back out. So I'm trying to get those.
I couldn't pull it off. I think maybe because I'm not tall enough. It was just too much shoe for my stature. Mm-hmm. And then you have to wear, I mean, I think they look really funny in shorts.
And really? I think they look better in shorts myself, but
I've never really, well, I didn't have them long enough to really compare, but it's just a big sneaker. It's just that sole is just ginormous. And I'm not talking like thick. I'm not like just everything.
Right.
So it's just, I don't know. It wasn't right for me. I didn't feel like wearing those like I feel like in the 700s.
Right. Oh, but the 700s, you're in a different tier because those are super rare. You got the 700. I mean, are you talking about the 700 V1s?
Yes.
Right. I personally don't like the 700 V1s as much because I think they look too much like a New Balance or something.
I think that's why I like it, because I'm a New Balance fan.
Yeah, exactly. It makes sense. We're cross patterned on that one. But I still respect the 700 V1, and I want to get at least one pair because I have all the other Vs pretty much. So I'm trying to get a pair of V1s.
So I was fortunate enough to get the Wave Runner, the Inertia Gray. I think it's called Inertia. Yeah. And then the Mocha ones, which the Mocha, there's like very little to no resale.
Yeah, but it don't matter, man. You got some V1s, bro. They're going to be more rare as time goes on, because if you notice, he releases less and less V1s, less and less 500s, but 350s are coming out all the time, and so are 380s right now.
True, and he's got another pair coming out too, the 700. I think it's called like a Sunrise.
Yeah, I know. Those Sunrises look crazy.
They're definitely crazy. I don't know if they're worth me trying to get, but they are definitely crazy.
Right.
And then I need more pitches.
They have another pair of 700 V3s that are black with brown, like all black and brown.
Black and brown.
Yeah, all black with brown. They almost look like an all black pair of 700 V3s, but they have a little bit of brown spots.
Oh, V3s. Yeah. Okay, I've seen those ones. Okay.
Yeah. So, like me and my boy Kazu, we hop up in the morning and try to log in and find and grab as many Yeezys as we can. We've just been flipping and hustling and trying to get them. And then in the process of the hustle, you keep extra pairs.
Right.
So we've been on it. So I think the hype on Yeezy really depends on the consumer. And like, are you a big Adidas supporter? Are you a Yeezy fan or not? Do you think Yeezys are cool or not? Because I have some friends like my boy Killa Sav, who's another, you know, sneakerhead. He's like, oh, man, you know, y'all never wear Yeezys. He's like, I'll never wear Adidas like that, you know. And I'm like, bro, you're saying that now. When you put a pair on, you might just change your mind. I was like, everyone doesn't like something until they get it themselves, you know. Everyone can say, you know, everyone would be like, oh, Lamborghini, oh, that's too much money. That's a silly car. Yeah, you get in and drive it for it up and down the freeway. You're like, I ain't so silly no more. Like,
facts. You know? No, you're right.
And that's what I mean. Yeah.
You're right. So we talked about Adidas and are Yeezy still hot? So no. I lightly mentioned something to you a little earlier. Now it's kind of venturing off, but it's kind of still on topic because it has to do with Adidas. And we talked about this brand a little earlier, Reebok.
Right.
So for those who don't know, Reebok is owned by Adidas.
Wow.
Next year, Adidas is selling Reebok. What are your thoughts? What do you think? What could happen?
Let's start with, who are they selling it to?
Don't know.
You know,
it's just out for sale. It's just putting it up for sale.
Who's rich enough to buy Reebok? So, I mean, there are some people, you know, maybe Pharrell will come by and buy it. Maybe, you know, Kanye West himself wants the power conglomerate and have it all. Like, you know, you never know.
Do you think, because remember how he mentioned that he wants to be on the board at Adidas.
Mm-hmm.
Reebok's a dope brand. Like, they got a lot of good stuff.
Yeah, definitely.
Do you think that Kanye could potentially buy Reebok and then start pushing his own stuff through Reebok?
I think so. I mean, he's done it. He pushed his own with Nike. He's pushing a hard line with Adidas. Might as well move on. He has to kind of do the thing like Nego and Pharrell did, which is they established like Bape, they established Billionaire Boys Club and Ice Cream, and then they moved on. Now Nego has Human Made. Now Pharrell's messing with Pharrell Originals with Adidas, and he's doing stuff with Chanel and every other brand. But then he did realize the moneymaker and came back and bought Billionaire Boys Club Ice Cream back, because he kind of like took his shares kind of away and then came back. And now that he's back on the board, the brand is blowing back up. It's like the prints look better. Everything's better when Pharrell's back in the building. So what I feel is why wouldn't he? You know, I think it's a smart move that you go buy Reebok. You still have all that classicness of the Yeezys that you dropped at Adidas. And if Adidas goes, okay, we're going to stop the Adidas Yeezy line, he could say, fine, I'm going to have the Reebok Yeezy line. And everyone's going to still buy them. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Yeah. And it'll just make all those Adidas ones go up in value. And he does everything he said he wanted to do to make Yeezy jump over the jump, man. That's what he's been saying. He's been saying it and he's sticking to it. He's like, I'm the modern day William Shakespeare. Like, he's saying right. these crazy things, and the funniest part is he's true. He's influencing the world in fashion, in music, and stuff. So, yeah, and now, even in politics. So that's crazy,
right? So now check this out. So you know the Boost material. I don't know if you know this or not, but the Boost material,
mm-hmm.
Adidas doesn't own that material. He doesn't own that technology in the sole.
Wow.
Puma actually had it first.
Wow.
So I don't know if you know that or not. So Puma, Puma had it first. Mm-hmm. They called it something else. Mm-hmm. It's like I think it's called like a BPU or something like that. I mm-hmm. don't remember the technical stuff. It's been quite a while. Mm-hmm. But you like they sell insoles on Instagram that are Boost material. So you can essentially put Boost in any sneaker that you have. I actually have a pair of insoles. I bought them. I wanted to check them out, and they are comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And I put them in my threes.
Nice.
So my threes, all my Jordan threes have Boost technology in them, technically.
Nice.
So, but what I'm getting at is that if Kanye wanted to, for example, buy Reebok because mm-hmm. Adidas is selling it, if he wanted to buy Reebok, he can buy Reebok and still put that same material that everyone loves into that, into his shoe.
Yep.
So, I mean, that's just putting that out there too. But I mean, realistically, would he really branch out and leave? Probably not, but you're also looking at other brands like, I mean, Fila could potentially. Mm-hmm. You have a no name. I mean, New Balance could. Anybody that's big, Nike. I would love and hate to see Nike buy Reebok. Mm-hmm. I don't even think they want to. I mean, they bought Converse.
I'm about to say, I know that one. I knew that one already, which is classic. That Converse. Was a great move in a certain sense because a Converse shoe is as a American. Staple, and not just American, Euro, everywhere. Yep. It's a Chuck Taylor is just iconic. I mean, that's what's saving Converse is the Chuck Taylor. I mean, the Converse has nothing else out that really like holds a light to anything else. It's a Chuck Taylor is because it's one of the classic American shoes. Therefore, people still, you know, hold Converse as a classic shoe to have. Because I just actually picked up a lot of Converse classics, and not only classics, collabos. They have all these different collabos with different European companies and stuff, and I bought a lot of them. And they are fire. When you wear them, they look like vape. They look like ice cream. They look like all these crazy stuff. And people, when I wear them and stuff, they're like, what are those? Like, they're like, those are crazy looking Chucks. I'm like, yeah, these are like collabo Chucks. Like, these aren't your regular Chucks. And they're like, oh, those are crazy. So Chucks are still fire.
Excuse me. And so to be fair, do I like Converse? I mean, I know we kind of branched out, but do I like Converse? No, not at all. I will never own a pair. Do I respect them? Yes.
Right.
So, but I just won't. So, but I mean, we'll see. So I would like to see what Nike or a company like Nike would do with Reebok.
Mm-hmm.
But it would be the worst thing for me as a Reebok fan,
right?
Because then you're looking at the
phone. Yeah.
Well, but then you're looking at, will you be able to get a pair? I mean, now you're going to have Reebok essentially on the sneakers app, like some Converse are,
mm-hmm.
and you're going to catch more L's. They're gonna flood the market with a bunch more, you know, crap. Mm-hmm. Basically, quality is going to go down because the quality right now on Reebok is amazing.
Oh yeah.
I haven't gotten one pair of Reeboks, and this is question or not. I haven't gotten one pair that were bad quality.
That's
good. All good quality.
I agree. All my pairs I got recently are fire.
So Nike, if you're listening, please. I know I don't really care for you, although my closet is full of your apparel and my sneaker room is full of your kicks, and I'm looking right here, right at you. Do not buy Reebok.
Yeah, and you know, I just don't want to see stuff like Reebok's doing all sorts of collabs. So let's do a small segue into Reebok. Reebok has just recently dropped the Ghostbusters collabo, which sold out in 10 seconds. I kid you not. I was sitting on the countdown timer. When it went to 000, I went to buy now and it said sold out. I was like, how does that even happen? Like, how does that even happen? Like, literally, Dante, every pair sold in seconds. Like I couldn't, and I'm an enthusiast and a purchaser of shoes. Like I get up and I get on the apps and websites like everyone else does, and waiting in line, all the bullshit online. But right. Those sold out literally in seconds. Like I was sitting there for the countdown, like 3, 2, 1, I'm about to buy, gone. I'm like, how did the whole site stop go in seconds like that? And then, and it wasn't just the Ecto One, because they have the shoe called the Ecto One, which is right. Based off of the car in Ghostbusters. Yep. And it looks just like it has all the wires and stuff. It looks really cool. It looks like a proton pack on the shoe. Yep. And then they have the shoe that looks like the uniform. It's like tan and it has like the little caution tape on the back, and then the Ghostbusters symbol right up on the toe. I mean, the tip of the top of the shoe. Those sold out in seconds too. I was so mad because I'm a huge Ghostbuster fan. I'm, you know, born in the 80s. Right. I wanted to get them. They were gone. I was like, this is crazy. So hype is crazy, even for Reebok. Because yeah. You wouldn't think that people were sitting there just hawking them like that, but they are. Same thing with the Beepers and Butts and the Name Chains Ice Cream Billionaire Boys Club shoes. You didn't think that everyone and their mom would be on them, but they were.
I didn't even know they dropped those ones.
Even though they dropped. And then, you know, they continue to drop little drops here and there. You know, both of us, we both own the Reebok Zig Kineticas, yep. A Billionaire Boys Club edition. And those are fire. I mean, they have glow in the dark. They have 3M reflector. Those are crazy. They're just absolutely crazy. So Reebok does a lot of great collabs with companies like Billionaire Boys Club and Ice Cream and Ghostbusters and stuff like that. And they keep doing stuff like that in Iverson and stuff. And I want to keep those coming. Like Reebok is a good option to have like a different, unique shoe that everyone isn't wearing, that only people who have an appreciation for old school style and shoe connoisseurism would wear.
Yep. So right now I'm gonna hashtag us Bach boys.
Yes, sir. Bachtober. Oh. Off the Bach. Yep. You know what I mean? The Bach boys.
and we'll keep it going. Well, so the next topic that we wanted to go over was the BBC Ice Cream Rare sneaker drops. Now, right. Were there any more that you wanted to cover? Because I know we've actually been kind of talking about those a lot.
Right.
Through it,
and we talked about the other one that's coming too. Supposedly, we got to stay tuned for even more. So, one of my sources behind the scenes, big shout out to Ice Cream Troop. You know, what I mean, that's the one of the young gods in the Ice Cream Billionaire Boys Club and Bape Game. You know, he told me, he said, "B man, stay in tune, stay in route." He's like, "I'm in route, I'm in tune, I know what's coming." B, he let me know about so much before it came. I can't even lie. So you know, he's kind of like, and he posts a lot, and people just don't pay attention to the symbols. He puts them up like hieroglyphics, like you got to put it together. Like he's letting you know stuff is coming. If you don't pay attention or do the research, you ain't gonna get them. But luckily, I stay in route and in tune, my young ninja, and I'm like, yo, you know what's popping, what's about to, you know, what's coming, you know, I know. Okay. You know what's coming, and he'd be like, B, something's coming, and he'd be letting me know, and then I'd be kind of ready for him. So they got a lot of new drops coming. We just got to stay tuned. You know, they keep surprising us. You know.
Okay, so far I mean, I like the two question lows that came out. The Beepers and Butts and name change, right?
Yep.
So those ones, I did like those. Those to me would fall under the category of a sleep. Now, right. The ones we brought up earlier, the Running Dogs, those are phenomenal heat. But those ones are heat because it's subtle. Now, I know BBC has a long history with being like, BBC and Bape have like kind of a long history with being very loud and having like all over print and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So that to me, for me, would fall under the sleep category.
Right.
If they start dropping stuff that's a little bit more subtle, then like, so another one I think is the, oh no, that's Cameron, where it has like that camo purple toe.
Yeah, those are fire.
But see how like the rest of the sneaker was like a plain, and then the camo toe was purple camo toe was just the toe itself. To me, like that is kind of like it's subtle, but it's not. But that's what I like.
Mm-hmm.
Do I like something? I mean, colors are different, but if you're gonna have a print or something like that, to me, that's something that, you know, I have to kind of pick and choose which one I really like. So hopefully BBC's got some stuff coming out where it's loud and a little bit more low key.
Yeah, and a lot of the fans and the huge supporters of the Billionaire Boys Club, Star Trek, and Ice Cream movement, they're really upset with them not bringing back out the boutiques. And the boutiques, for people who don't know what I'm talking about, are the low top ice creams that had the pagers on them and the lipsticks and the teddy bears and the name chains and all that type of stuff. They're the original style that they're kind of retro printing onto the Iversons and stuff. Because the original ones didn't look like that. They look more like a low top Stan Smith. They look like a Stan Smith.
Right.
They have
like a classic.
Yeah. They look like a Stan Smith classic, but they have, you know, amazing prints on them and colors, and they have the Billionaire Boys Club logos and stuff. They came out in the early 2000s. Those are called boutiques, and those are what everyone wants them to redrop. Now, they dropped an ice cream made in Italy, and I believe on one of the shows I already brought them on with GC. But since I'm on with you, we could take a quick look at them if you want, right before we get out of here. So if you want to look at them, let's take a look at the ice cream made in Italy real quick.
Sure.
So these are them right here, right off the wall, right? So these are them, and they come in these cool ice cream bags. You know what I'm saying? So check them out. So the Made in Italy is really dope because each shoe's different. So here's the Made in Italy. And this is more like how the boutiques were.
Okay.
It says ice cream right there.
That leather looks crazy.
The bottom says ice cream.
Inside, is that rubber?
Yeah, it's like a plexiglass.
Yeah.
It's like a plexiglass. If you look in close, there's embroidery, stitching, dollars and diamonds on there. It's crazy detail. This is all Italian leather. Also,
the material looks insane.
Yeah, it has the ice cream on the tongue right there too. The same like swirly logo inside, but it's blue.
Okay.
But here's the fun of this shoe. So, and this is how it looks. These were $400 retail. These are super rare. These are both DS, and I'll show you why. These are made in Italy. They're very limited. Like they're one of the rare shoes on the planet. Period.
Okay.
And they came mismatched. And here's the other one. It's pink. So it's
sick. That's dope.
And the diamonds and dollar signs. So these are called the Made in Italy ice creams right here.
Okay.
They're really sick.
See the bottom of the pink one?
Sure.
Ice cream in pink? Oh, okay.
Yeah. But these, you can't find these. I'm telling you. Go ahead. Everyone out there watching this, go to StockX. Go to your goat. Go wherever you want. You ain't even going to find these.
He said, go to your goat.
Yeah, go to all that. You ain't gonna find any. These are super gems. These are infinity gems right here. And it takes a certain style to wear them. Now, you know, when I was talking with GC about them, he's kind of like, you know, that's not my style shoe. And a lot of people would say that. But damn it, if you have the sickest Miami colorways on and you're out on vacation somewhere tropical and you have these on with a boss fit, I'm sorry, you're crushing people. These are so rare and they're so tight and they come mismatched. So that makes them kind of fun.
Those are dope. I mean, could I pull them off? No, I couldn't pull them off, even with the smaller foot in my size. Mm-hmm. But I mean, I can't pass up the fact that they are dope.
Yeah, and made with 100% Italian leather. They're imported. They're sick, and they were very, very hard to get, and so expensive. So like, they sold out fast, and they were $400 retail. So it was like, wait a minute, what? You know? So, but it was worth it. I got them, and I was like, man, I got one of the rarest ice cream Billionaire Boys Club gems you can get, and because I'm a super collector of that. Realm and stuff. So it's pretty sick.
Okay. All right. We'll move on to the next one. So the next one was another one you brought up is sneaker shopping with celebrities.
Right.
What were you getting at with that one? Because I have a couple of different options on that. So what were you looking for? So that way I know.
I like the one with Fabulous. When they go for sneaker shopping with Fabulous, and he comes in inside the Yeezy slides, and then he's like, man, I'm about to leave with a pair. And he like actually wears a pair that matches his fit he's wearing to leave with.
Right.
I really like that episode because just seeing Fab shopping is great. Next to Fab shoe shopping, I have to say, I really, really, really love seeing Jim Jones shopping. Oh, he is so funny. He's so funny. He just kept the comedy rolling. Like, oh man, Jim Jones shopping made it. It was an experience watching him shoe shopping and like how he just like, man, we getting these. He's like, these are the Coke White Air Forces. These are the Uptowns. You can't not have these, you know. And these like every dope dealer, every hustler, every gangster had these. And I'm just like, oh, he's not only buying these shoes or he's not only telling us a story about them. He's giving us pure history about it. And like. Right. And from an OG in hip hop and rap. So I loved seeing that. So yeah, the sneaker shopping with the celebs, all the different episodes are funny. And they even got one with Pamela Harris recently and stuff. So
yeah,
it's great.
So I got to say, I think my favorite ones so far that I've seen, period, on there have been the two Action Bronson ones.
Oh, no.
Action Bronson. Funny. Yeah, right. Action Bronson. That's that dude. So, yeah. But overall, I like it when the celebs that show up or the guest shoppers that show up, where they have like actual sneaker knowledge, where they're actual sneaker heads. Now, I understand that if they were to try and do that, they wouldn't be able to put out as many shows. They wouldn't be able to have it every week or every other week. Right. Right. I understand that. But as someone who's just giving my opinion, so for example, the what was her name? The Harris lady.
Kamala Harris, the future possible vice president.
Yes. So I'm kind of on the fence with that one because I like that she got on there and I like that she used it as a platform to expose it to, you know, to vote and, you know, to get younger people in there because that's, you know, really who watches the show is, you know, younger people, typically the people who don't vote.
Right.
So I appreciate that. Now, did I enjoy watching her on the show talking about sneakers really? No. Because I felt like she was pretending to talk about sneakers the entire time.
Right.
I do appreciate Joe LaPluma speaking up and like trying to grab sneaker topics out of her. And I understand that. But that's not really what I want to see. Like, I want to see like the Jim Jones. I want to see like, you know, like even, and I'm a fan of 50 Cent, but I really didn't care for when he was on it because he wasn't talking about sneakers.
Right.
He was talking about it. Yeah. Exactly. It's sneaker shopping. Like, bring up the history. Bring up your history in sneakers. Mm-hmm. So, like, Alicia Keys, like, I love Alicia Keys, but same thing. She wasn't on there talking about the actual sneakers and reminiscing, you know, stuff like that. Like, Fabulous was.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, definitely. Fabulous was, and just various people. So, I'm on the fence when it comes to sneaker shopping. I just think it's to the point now to where they're just using it as a platform to just promote whatever that person's doing.
Right. And, I agree with you because when Kamala Harris went on there, I wanted to hear more of what shoes she just loves wearing. But she kept, you know, talking about the importance of voting and all that stuff. And she did mention about, you know, Chuck Taylors are my favorite shoe and stuff like that. So she gave us a hint, but did use it for the gradual boost of the election and stuff. So, you know, what I appreciate about it is that we generally won't see a presidential candidate or person even come onto a shoe show. So for her to come onto a shoe show and even talk about one shoe, which is the Chucks or whatever, that's still something good. It's showing that we had a candidate who at least cared about people and to touch them in a way that they could be reached. So that's what I appreciate about it. Just what you said, the same thing. I feel, but I wanted to hear a little more about it. You know, so growing up, what did a Chuck mean to you a little?
Right.
Like whatever it was. So that's what was missing from her segment. But besides that, it was cool. Like I didn't mind it. But I love just seeing the rappers and stuff going there. Like I love when Cordae went on there, took the shoes up to the counter. She rang them up. It was like $7,000. He's like, wait a minute. Them Ducks is 3Gs, man. You can take those off.
Yep.
You're right. Funny. Like, I just find that so funny. I'm like, wow. He's like, I think he's the first person who told someone to take something back.
Yep.
Like,
you're right.
No. So
back. And that's also what I like about the show as well. Mm-hmm. Is I don't like the I mean, first off, they're going to the wrong spots, man. Yeah. Wrong spots. Why are they going? I mean, whatever. I know, you know, if you as a rapper, I understand, you know, the having the money and all this and that, and you gotta spend it and floss it, and that's kind of what way before you were even born that's what they wanted. You know what I mean? That was always the image of what it was. Well, actually, no, not before you were born. But anyway, so it was always the image of having money and flossing and this and that.
Mm-hmm.
But I appreciated that episode because that was real. That was the most real. But I don't like where they go shopping at.
Because Fight Club and all that stuff.
All that stuff is that all. I mean, I don't shop there. That's not where the... why spend more because you have more money? That's not how you keep money. That's not how you make money.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? They could have gone. They bought the same sneaker for half the price.
Right. Exactly.
So, I mean, I don't know. I've always said to myself, like, I hope that these people are getting like a discount, like afterwards, like they're just doing it for the front of spending, you know, $500 for Jordan 3.
Right. Right. But I honestly don't think so.
I don't think so either. I'm just saying I hope.
Yeah, exactly.
If not, I mean, go to Palaka. Go to somewhere else. Go here, go there. I mean, Flight Club is getting more notoriety for being on these shows regularly.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I love when Kamala Harris, when she went to, what was it? I think it was Atlanta. not Sneaker Politics. Oh, it lost me. I watched the episode, but she is in a local mom and pop sneaker boutique.
Right.
So, and it's famous. I've shopped there several times, but that's where I like them to be. Go to a sneaker boutique that is a mom and pop, not a flight club to where they're all they're doing is reselling sneakers. And I know they got to make their money too, but I mean, why? Why pay that price?
Mm-hmm. And you hit the nail on the head about it. It is about floss potential. It is showing everyone that your money's up and that you're here just blowing it like it's nothing. I mean, that's a part of why that show's successful is because they're promoting that to people to get their will up to try to do that themselves. And that's harsh because people can break their pockets trying to be overly influenced by who they see. Because what they don't realize is all that is subliminal programming that they just don't realize that they're going through is making them want to be like other people and stuff, especially the new youth who don't have their own identity, who kind of look to celebrities for identity and stuff like that. So, yeah, it can be a dangerous thing, even, you know, promoting that too much, because you're just showing everyone to break their pockets on expensive stuff that's for some people not at this moment attainable, and they're going to do all types of links to get to it. So
you're 100%, and that's why I'm not a fan, and I will only watch now. I used to watch it regularly, time I saw a post up, I would watch it regularly. Then I started just noticing that trend, and I'm like, you know what, now I only watch it when it's not a sneaker person, but a celeb that I'm like, okay, maybe this is a potential actual sneakerhead.
Right.
And then I'll watch it.
Mm-hmm. What about Full Size Run? I love that show.
You know, I gotta say, Fab Five, Jalen Smith.
Mm-hmm.
The Jalen Smith episode, generally, I like watching Full Size Run.
Right.
Okay. Generally, I like watching Full Size Run. Mm-hmm. That episode, though, have you watched it?
No. Yeah, where Jalen's on there with the glasses.
Yo, bro, Trinidad James was pissing me off, man. He kept yelling.
Right.
He kept screaming. So I listened to him like in headphones or on the TV.
Bro,
I felt like my TV speakers were about to blow. He kept screaming. Like, I understand the excitement behind it, but no, and. What I do like is I do like how Trinidad James is an actual sneakerhead. Mm-hmm. And I really watch, I mean, the other two, Matt Welty and Jason Dunn, they're cool. Jason Dunn seems to me to be a little bit more into sneakers. Mm-hmm. I don't really care for Matt Welty's kind of take on it, but he fits. So I'm okay with it.
The guy who's all for Boktober and stuff?
No, that's Jason Dunn.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So him I like a little bit more, but Matt Welty, like I don't know. He's just
there.
He brings something to the table, and if it was any other two guys, I don't think he would work.
Right.
But because they have that three, that combo of the three of them, I think it works.
Yeah, I love the show. I think it's funny, and the comedy is funny, and I like how they do little subtle references to hip hop and put up little quotes and little funny sayings and stuff. And
yeah,
I think they've done a real good job of editing it and like making it like a cooler show. So I do like Full Size Run, and that's something I watch alongside the sneaker shopping with celebs and stuff. So
sneaker shopping, like I said, I've kind of stepped away from that. I don't like where it's gone. I do like that they brought someone in, like an actual real person who did that, like the competition or I forgot what it was, but basically won a chance to go sneaker shopping. I thought that was cool.
Right.
So, but the Full Size Run, I've been a consistent fan of Full Size Run. And mainly because I really like Trinidad James and the fact that he's a sneakerhead. If they were to have like one or two more sneakerheads, and granted, I'm not me, but I don't want Jason Dunn or Matt Welty to lose their job to be on the show. But if there was a show with, you know, similar, but like all three sneakerheads, I would absolutely love that.
Right. Real sneakerheads. Yeah. Like hardcore, not because the problem with them is one of them is a Reebokist to the core,
which I'm okay with because I like Reebok.
I know. Of course you would. but what I mean is, for the regular watcher, he does so much bashing of other shoes that I get a little annoyed with that. I want somebody who's like, I want a person who's like an across the board person. Like Trinidad James is across the board.
Yep.
Like the other guy is not across the board either. Like they're not across the board. Like I think I need three across the board people so we get a deeper insight to shoes and culture. When you get one person who's just a Reebokist or one who's an Adidas only person, every time they talk about a Nike or Jordan, I don't like that. You know.
Right.
And so you know that's kind of hard to swallow. as a viewer when you're trying to figure out, you know, what you want to start getting on, or if you're trying to, you know, look for something new or try something out different in your style.
Yeah. And I look for the times that, you know, especially I think Matt Welty, he's mainly the one that will say like, oh, Jordan, like, no, I don't like Jordan. I don't like Jordan. And, but mm-hmm. I look for those times when he was like, I kind of like that.
Right.
When it's like a Jordan. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, things like that. So does it work for those three? Yes. Would I like to see something where it's mainly more three sneakerheads? Definitely.
Right.
But, you know, I'll take what I can get. And that is that they're doing a great job. And I fully support, and I have been fully supporting. I mean, it's just like Nike. Like I'll compare it to Nike as to where, whereas I love what Nike's doing. I love their product. Do I really like Nike? No.
Right.
Because I mean, because they're a-holes. You know what I mean? There's so many things that they could do better, but I continuously support. They continuously give my money. Kind of same thing.
Yeah.
So that's where I'm at with that one.
Yeah. I mean, that's fair to say.
Yeah. All right. So now we're going to segue into, and it's probably going to be a little bit more, it's not going to take as long, but I want to segue into the up part of sneakers and up. So there's a couple of added on things that I wanted to bring up. But first and foremost, do you have a sleeper sneaker of the week?
The sleeper sneaker of the week. Yes, it would have to be the Ghostbusters Ecto-1 Reebok release that just came out yesterday. That's a sleeper of the week, and it's hitting on StockX.
Really?
Yeah.
I kind of wish, because I have premium membership access to Reebok. Because I bought so much, I kind of wish now I would have copped a pair, but you know,
You really should have, because they look like Buzz Lightyear shoes. They're crazy. They look like they look like Ecto-1, the car / Buzz Lightyear / the Proton Pack they wear in one.
True.
Shoe. And then the other ones that look like the uniform, those are classics. They're the Reebok Classic Lows, actual classics, but they have a canvas material. And then, you know, it has the Ghostbusters little name tag on it, but instead of Ghostbusters or the member name, it says Reebok. And then at the top, it has the actual symbol, and the back, it has the caution tape that's yellow and black. I was like, those are fire. And on the small side, a little splash of neon green slime. Like the slime was like,
I didn't see that.
Oh, it's tight. It's tight.
Now, I mean, I kind of wish I would have got them, but again, about what I like, and I saw them, and they really didn't hit that number for me, so I kind of just passed.
Right.
But okay, so that's your sleeper of the week. Mine is coincidentally another Reebok, but it's a Reebok Legacy.
Mm.
Have you seen those?
No, I haven't, but I'm taking a look at them now.
Okay, Reebok Legacy. Now, there's multiple different colors. It's nothing really special with the sneaker, but I got to tell you, the $80 retail.
Right.
And they are crazy comfortable.
Okay.
Crazy comfortable. So, I mean, that to me is a huge sleeper. I went from having zero pairs to now I have like six.
I might have to get a pair of those. All right, I'm looking at them. They're not too bad.
No. And there's crazy colors.
And how many how many colors do you have?
Six.
Damn. They're really cool. They look kind of trainer-ish.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. So now, remember, I don't like to pay retail. So if I don't pay retail, then I'm definitely not, or I probably won't own it, even at $80. So I have six pairs of those, and I did not pay retail, but those are crazy comfortable. I love rocking them, and they're just great to just throw on and, you know, go anywhere.
Mm-hmm. They look like it. They look like you can run a million miles on those. Those are tight.
Yes. All right. So, sorry. Now we're going to get into the up part of sneakers and up. So the first thing I wanted to talk about was Miles Morales. You know who that is, right?
Of course, Spider-Man. Okay,
perfect. I don't know, so I don't assume. So Miles Morales is entering the MCU universe.
Nice.
And but also they are bringing in or introducing the Spider-Verse universe into MCU.
Yes.
So Tobey Maguire, Andrew Garfield, and Tom Holland are all going to be in the MCU. I don't know the other two, whether it's just a little bit, a stint, or whatever, but they're all going to be officially in the MCU.
Mm-hmm. Now, did they cast Miles Morales yet?
I believe they were holding auditions.
Okay, yeah. I mean, that's one of the most important characters.
Yes. Now, I am full, like, they need to bring the voice actor from the Miles Morales animated movie, they need to bring him, I think. Unless
he,
they
he looks the role too.
He I forget his name, and I forget his name. I'm not gonna look it up, but he plays he was on the Jordan 1 Spider-Man. He was doing the promos for those.
Oh, okay.
So I think if he shaved his face, I think he looks young enough.
Okay.
I think if he shaved his, I mean, oh, he's got like his little mustache or maybe a goatee, but if he shaved that, I think he looks young enough. And I think he's light-skinned enough to look Puerto Rican and black.
Right.
Because that's what Miles Morales is. So I think he has that. I think the cartoon character did, the animated cartoon character did a good job on like kind of capturing what he looked like in real life. So I'm going to be slightly disappointed if they don't bring him in.
Right, because he's the actual voice and it would tie it all together.
Yes, and yes, exactly. And I think he's a great actor too. He was in The Get Down on Netflix.
Oh yeah, that was an epic 80s recap.
Yeah, series. So you've seen it, right?
Yeah, of course.
He's the older, like the mentor.
Yeah, I know who it is.
Yeah, okay, yeah. So that's him.
Yeah.
So I think they need to bring him in. So I'm crazy excited for all of the Spider-Mans to come in. I still can't believe that Fox agreed to it. And as a fan, I'm like, I'm crazy juice for this.
I'm excited too. I actually love Into the Spider-Verse as one of my favorite Spider-Man movies. I just, even though it was animated, it was such a thrill ride. Facts. And I saw it in 3D. And oh my God, when I saw it in 3D on IMAX, I was in the Spider-Verse. Like I was sitting in there and on a gigantic IMAX screen with 3D, it was like, that was game was like being on mushrooms or something. It's like, whoa! You know, your eye, like all these visuals and colors, and it's like it, for people, you know, it was a pure psychedelic thrill ride. Like that movie is epic.
It's absolute nuts. The movie is amazing alone, like you said. But then the storyline was crazy. The acting, the voice acting was nuts. To have Miles Morales actually be an active character in anything is super dope.
Yeah, I'm excited for that. And I'm really excited for the African-American, Latin, and Afro-Latin community with that, because that's showing more diversity in superheroes. And, you know, we first kind of seen that in this new era with Black Panther, really holding the torch up. Yep, RIP to Chadwick Boseman, you know what I mean? One of the most tragic losses in history. He was more than just an actor.
He was an activist and just a real superhero.
He's a real superhero. He was the Black Panther. He was the King of Wakanda, like in RIP. But, you know, he helped really show everyone the importance of ethnic actors. And we need to see more of that in movies. We need to see more Asian. We need to see like a big Asian superhero. We need to see another Latino superhero. We need to see the faces of what the world is as the heroes, because it's not just one face. It's not just one shade. It's all the shades of us that make the world important and big. So that's what we need to see more of in Marvel Comics, in Star Wars, in all this stuff. And we have seen it increase over the years. So at least I can see an increase in it. If I start seeing a decrease, then I'll be upset. But not to overly segue into stuff, what I don't like is when movies misrepresent people's race and stuff like that. For example, any movies with Egyptians and they're all non-black people, stuff like that. It's like that's not historically accurate. So I think that just keeping things accurately in perspective historically, or when they're referring back to ancient stuff, because they kind of do in some of the stories and stuff, they go back to showing ancient memories and stuff, make sure that that's portrayed correctly. And so I think making Miles Morales the Afro-Latin ethnicity was such a good idea for Marvel and good idea for Spider-Man, to give Spider-Man a new twist and a new story, and to give people who are black and who are Latino or Afro-Latino and any race a bigger scope of culture and understanding, that it's not just this wake up and have pancakes and have bacon and this American vision of like, you know, how it has to be. It's, you know, he might wake up and he might be making, you know, more ethnic food or something. And then the people from that culture see that and like, oh, he's making, you know, he's making this, he's doing that. And it kind of ties it all together. So yeah, I'm really, really excited about that. So I'm just excited as you are. So that's dope that you brought it up.
Yeah. So, and then, and just to kind of venture off a little bit, and it has to do with Miles Morales, but Miles Morales is, Spider-Man is coming out for the PS5.
Yep.
Now I just saw it. I think it was either this morning or late last night. Mm-hmm. So they are having do you play? I know you play competitive, but do you play like the Spider-Mans and the RPG open world kind of games?
I play all sorts of games, but I did hear that you get the old Spider-Man with that when we pre-order it, which is dope.
No, so the one I heard this morning, and it's solidified. I am 100% going to pre-order now. Mm-hmm. So when you pre-order, I guess you can buy it later. It's a skin. But when you pre-order, you get the Miles Morales Enter the Spider-Verse. Not only the skin, so you get the suit, you get you unlock so many things with that suit. So you know how in the game, how he kind of like skipped a little bit and had that little dotty kind of look?
Mm-hmm.
You get that. Mm-hmm. You get different fighting, swinging, playing animations. So like if you're swinging and you let go of the web and you're floating for a little bit and then you come back and, you know, shoot the web to swing again, you'll get him kind of do like turn around and put his hands behind his head.
I'll do the funny cool stuff.
All that stuff. And then in fighting, when you fight, you get the pow and pap and zing. Like the bubbles will pop up.
Nice. That's a classic.
Like from the Spider-Verse. So all of that is animated from Enter the Spider-Verse.
Nice.
I have to have it.
I'm with you on that. I'm definitely pre-ordering for sure. I'm probably pre-ordering it this week because I got my PS5 coming next week. So I'm excited.
Okay, well then I'm jealous then.
Yeah, well it's coming on, you know, November. I get it like the first on the first wave. I got the first wave pre-order. Okay. So those are like set for the second week of November, second week. So it won't be next week. Okay. Week after. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So that was the Miles Morales. Second is Black Widow is rumored to come out for Disney Plus premiere.
Hmm.
Do you have Disney Plus? Are you on Disney Plus?
Yes,
well, I guess for The Mandalorian.
Yeah. I'm always a Disney Plus fan and Avengers fan. I'm not a big Black Widow fan.
Okay.
I'll tell you why. I am all for female superheroes. Okay. I love Rey from Star Wars. I think Wonder Woman's tight. I love like all the black superheroes who are from the Wakandan army and Black Panther. I love women superheroes. I think Black Widow is way too OP and way too weak to be that OP. So let's put it, for example, there are people flying around, shooting beams out of their hands and stuff, opening portals and magic, doing this stuff. She's out there punching people, flipping around and shooting them with guns. I'm sorry. I can't buy that. When somebody can just lift you up and disintegrate you, you're going to shoot them or go, hey, stop, or punch them. Come on, man. Like, I can't rock with that. She, like, the people she's up against, did you see the people she was up against in Infinity War and all that stuff? Yes. Those guys who were Thanos' minions would destroy Black Widow. There's no way she could even hold a light to them. So
well, I think that's probably why she died before that.
Right. But what I mean, though, is that
I get what you're saying.
I'm talking about like in Infinity War and stuff like that. Where
exactly,
Infinity War, where she's fighting Thanos' minions.
I'm sorry,
that girl that's from Thanos' minions would just destroy her. The one that was like, "You'll pay for that," when they killed her friend. No, like Black Widow can't hang with real superpowered beings. Like, I'm sorry, like she can hang with just the humans and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I give her that. Like, on a human level, go for it. You're a trained Soviet espionage, you know, you're doing flips, you got cool power bracelets at most.
She's not a Scarlet Witch.
She is far from it. So how is she even running around with people who have powers like that and able to compete against the people that they're fighting against? I don't understand it.
Well, you know how Hawkeye was self-aware. He called himself out. He said, people are flying and this and that, and I'm out here with a bow and arrow.
Right. But Hawkeye has an ability that's too crazy. He hardly ever misses. So when he takes a shot or
something.
So you got to think about it. He's used in a tactical situation. Let's just say we're going to get him in close enough so he can like shoot explosive arrow at that box over there that's going to break the force field to let us in. But Black Widow can't do that because Black Widow doesn't miss. I mean, will miss, like has a bigger room to miss than Hawkeye does. And Hawkeye has a crazy skill set where he's able just to not miss. So if you're fighting with someone who shoots and doesn't miss, that's a power in itself.
That's fair.
But Black Widow is just a really good fighter who has spy training right. You know, and can get and can, you know, get out of being trapped or captured, which is a good ability, you know. So when they capture her, she can get out and then, you know, go free her friends and stuff. But as far as being out on the field fighting, I don't think she can really hold up to Thanos' minions, Thanos, anyone like that.
That's fair.
Yeah.
So now you spoke about her. Now, do you now are you aware of what is supposed to come out in the movie?
No.
From my understanding, and if I did my research correctly, I believe the Black Widow movie is supposed to be the first introduction of a mutant.
Oh, okay.
If I heard this correctly, and everything makes sense, everything falls in line. So the first mutant to be kind of exposed is Omega Red.
Nice. Because I know that that Taskmaster is supposed to be in the movie, but I didn't know about Omega Red.
I think he like shows up.
Okay, but Omega Red is the villain. That's crazy.
No. I don't think he's the villain. Kind of like how Thanos, you know, how remember how Thanos was like at the very, very end and it just showed him like his side of his face, but you knew who it was.
Right.
I think it's going to have kind of like an approach kind of like that to where like they'll either mention him or they'll show like a quick little something, maybe like a flashback. I don't know, but I don't think he's going to be like prevalently in the movie. I think he's just going to be either referenced or shown. But from what I understand, he's going to be introduced.
Okay, that's going to be lit. Yeah, and he needs to. That's going to help cross X-Men into there.
And I cannot wait for that. I'm a ginormous X-Men fan.
Right.
Above everything else. So that's why, like, when the MCU started happening, I liked the X-Men movies for what they were, but ultimately I was disappointed on how everything worked. Like, I think they did X-Men way too soon, but I like that they actually brought them out, that they started with them. Kind of. But they have a... But now that MCU was taking X-Men, the possibilities are endless.
Oh yeah,
absolutely endless, and I'm super excited for what they got coming.
Count me in for that one. I'm there,
man. Okay, so did you get Mulan? Have you seen Mulan?
No, not yet.
Okay, Mulan is pretty dope too, and I like how everything kind of worked in there. Now it did have a lot of how do you put it? Matrix style martial arts.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the flying around on wires.
Yeah. So it had a lot of that, which kind of threw me off. I wasn't really expecting it. Was it bad? No. Was it expected? Well, for you, yes. But for me, no, it was not.
Right.
So that kind of threw me off a little bit, but the acting was good. The storyline was good. Now, anyone listening, keep in mind that hold this separate than the cartoon.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, and it's hard to do, but hold it separate than the cartoon. If you watch it as a standalone movie, it's a good movie. If you base it off the cartoon, just like everything else, almost in history, when you try to trying to compare the two, it's gonna fall short.
Right.
So, all right. And the last topic that we want to cover is Blade is coming to the MCU. Mahershala Ali is gonna be Blade. What are your thoughts on that?
I'm here for it. He looks very like Wesley Snipes in his prime. What he lacks is martial arts ability. So Wesley Snipes is a true martial artist. That will make a difference in the fighting. So they're going to have an incredible stuntman, or they're going to have to train the shit out of him for every scene. So every scene, he's going to have to take some serious martial arts training, because Wesley Snipes fighting is believable. I mean, because he's an actual martial artist. So that's the only tiff I have with that. But he did great. Mr. Ali did great in Battle Angel Alita. He played a great villain in that movie. And like all of his other movies that he's played in, which are way more epic than Battle Angel Alita, by the way, in acting capability, are so good. Like, he's such a great actor. He plays a great villain. So to see him as a hero is going to be nice.
Anti-villain or anti-hero.
Okay. And to see him as an anti-hero, you know, a Wolverine of sorts, it's going to be really good to see. So I'm really excited about that. I'm excited to see a new Blade. And with all the technology we have now, it's going to make it so much sicker. So I can't wait.
It's going to be crazy.
And then I heard that Wesley's going to be in it, as well as he's supposed to play Whistler. He's supposed to play the guy. He's supposed to play Whistler.
That one I didn't hear about.
Oh, man. He's supposed to be Whistler, the guy who teaches him all the stuff and gives him the gadgets and stuff. And that's great. That would be a great segue. That'd be a
great callback. Callback.
They need that.
I didn't know that one. I didn't hear about that.
Now that may still be rumor, but I have heard that and read that several places. So hopefully that's true.
Well, because I know Wesley, he said he wanted to be Blade. But I mean, let's face it. And, you know, unfortunately, Wesley, I'm sorry. You know, Mr. Snipes, time doesn't permit that.
Right, right.
But I mean, he did great in the Blade Trinity.
Right.
Trinity. But I think Mahershala Ali is definitely going to be the future of Blade.
Yeah.
I saw Mahershala Ali as far as in this context, a superhero in Luke Cage.
Right.
So
he was in
he was in Luke Cage Netflix series.
Yeah. He was so good.
He killed it. He killed it. Mm-hmm. And that was actually his intro. Once he was in Luke Cage, I read an interview. He said his introduction into comics, movies was Blade or Luke Cage. So once he got his exposure to that, he really wanted to do Blade.
Nice.
So, and one thing led to another, and now he's in it. Now I can't wait. I'm ecstatic for what they got coming.
I can't wait either, man. It's going to be a real good 2020, whatever, when that drops. So I'm ready. And
past 2020 for sure. Yeah. Hopefully 2021 doesn't have the same kind of thing going on.
Gosh. Right. So, you know, that, and speaking of that, everybody out there, you know what I mean? Make sure y'all stay strong and make sure y'all, you know what I mean, keep your spirits, soul, and mind together through all this. And that's why we're here for all of y'all, to keep y'all positive and to make sure everyone's still collecting and still doing the things they love, like shoes, fashion, and everything. You can't lose grip of that just because of a crisis. So
don't fall into cabin fever. Cabin fever is a real thing. Don't do it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, don't do it. So the last before we walk out of here is going to be, the say what topic. Now we ended on the say what topic. Now, for those that don't know, say what topic is something that we find on social media that just either has us stuck, has us laughing incredibly, is a callback, just whatever it is. So we'll start with yours. And I'm going to go ahead and play it now.
I'm Leroy Green. Who are you?
Who am I?
Shut up!
I am the Shogun of Harlem. And the Leroy Green I'm looking for. Well, how about I leave him a little message then? Tell him when I found out he wasn't here. I was all broken up.
Oh, God, my table, what are you doing?
Crush me, Cyclone! Do it!
With pleasure!
No! Hold it, please, fellas. No, not like that. Please, don't hit me! Please, come on, for me. Don't hit me on the wall!
I'm gonna kill you, boy!
Take it easy, honey.
Alright, enough is enough. Y'all better chill out.
Richie, you stay out of this.
You better chill out, man. I said chill out.
Shut up, bitch. Chicken-hearted son of yours to name the place. Now he's got to fight me. Yeah.
All right, so describe that. What was your?
So that was a clip of from the movie, the epic 1980s karate comedy, The Last Dragon, and it's a scene where, sure enough, the Shogun of Harlem, he shows up and he's looking for his rival, Bruce Leroy, and he shows up to Bruce Leroy's dad's pizza parlor and he's like looking for him and stuff. And I mean, sure enough is iconic, and why I picked that clip is his outfit is such a great Halloween costume, like and not only that, I swear on everything, Busta Rhymes and the Serious, his old video, Dangerous, He did a little, "Hey, yo, Leroy!" He looked just like him too, and it was so good. Like, and I just like, showing up is such an iconic 80s villain. Like, I just love him. Yeah, he's so dope. So I just wanted to, you know, shout out and rest in peace to Shownuff. And for this Halloween edition, I had to pull that clip up because I saw it on Instagram the other day. I just couldn't help but repost it and laugh because I love that shit.
All right. So I got two, and I showed you one, but the second one I'll tell you. So I got two, and here's mine.
Check this out. So I'm at this place, Super Mercado El Rancho, and look what they got. They got a quinceañera, and then they have Panera Bread, some guy named Marco, some kind of fruit cafeteria or something, and then cocaine. They got all that shit in this Mexican restaurant. I'm going in.
I mean, I don't really have to say anything. The dude, first off, he was pulled up in front of that little rancherio.
Yep.
He called out everything so incorrect. And he got so excited when he said that the Mexican restaurant or Mexican place had cocaine. I think that's chocolate. But he was like, I'm going in there. But that had, when I saw that, I was rolling so hard. So hard. I was dying laughing. Like, that had everything in me.
That was funny as hell. When you said that to me, I was like, that's funny.
So, okay. So the next one is just the post that I saw, and I won't post this one or not, but just because I can read it. But it says, Megan Thee Stallion is 6'4 and 260 pounds talking about who gonna handle me. Bitch, the Cowboys, they need help on offense.
Oh, that's crazy. That's crazy. That's cold. Whoever wrote that is cold.
So say what? Say what? That's that one had me rolling, especially with the how the Cowboys are doing this year. And my half of my bloodline is from Texas, and they're all right. Cowboy fans. I was a Cowboy fan growing up. I'm a diehard Emmitt Smith fan himself. So right. When I read that, that had me absolutely dying laughing.
Now, before we even get out of here, you said one key word. We're both Reebok activists. The Reebok Emmitt Smiths back in the day were fire.
They need to come back out.
I was about to say, where have they been? Like, if you're lucky if you have a pair of those in like a good condition in this era. Those were amazing Reeboks along with the DMX lines.
Yep. Well, the DMX, the Run 10. But they did drop the ES22, and I think I brought this up on the podcast. They did come back out, I want to say roughly about 8 years ago. I had almost all the colors, but the problem is I dropped weight. So when I dropped weight, apparently I lost weight in my feet first. Excuse me. So they all got too big, too big for insoles. So I had to sell them all.
Wow.
So I'm really hoping that they revive that line, because I'm gonna have to go back in and buy every single pair.
Well, I'll get a pair of Emmitts that they drop ASAP. I won't even think
twice. I don't remember them.
The problem was in high school, I didn't even cop them. Like, one of my best friends had the Emmitt Smiths, and I was like, oh, those are fire Reeboks, because, you know, I was being a little bit more hardcore Nike at the exact time. But I ended up getting the Sean Kemps, which were really sick, all black Sean Kemps, and I got a lot of the DMX shoes and just all sorts of different Reeboks, you know, after some point. But those Emmitt Smiths really kicked it off in the world of Nike. When those Emmitt Smiths dropped, they were fire. So,
I had the I don't know the actual name, but I had the Emmitt Smith 2s.
Mm-hmm.
Those are the ones that I bought. I didn't get any of the Emmitt Smiths just because it time permitting, and you know, at that time parents were buying my kicks still, you know what I mean? So
right.
Couldn't really justify. So I got the opportunity, I bought the Emmitt Smith 2s, or they were bought for me, and I wore those things to the ground. They never left my feet. I wore those with so much pride.
You got to.
So I have to have those again. I tried looking them up. I can't find any for sale anywhere, even beat, used, anything.
Well, so, you know what we need to do? We need to get to writing Reebok. And you know what? Someone might hear it. We need to go ahead and write them. You need to go ahead and drop those. Yep. Just try.
Very true.
Hey, you never know until you try.
Facts. All right. So we're going to go ahead and end up on out of here. Keep in mind, everybody, that if you stay tuned to directly after the video, we're going to come on to Galaxy B's music video.
Yep. And that's going to be my video, S-Groove, filmed in Tokyo, Japan. You guys can check me out, www.soundcloud.com/DJGalaxyB, at DJGalaxyB on Instagram and DRB3000 on Twitter. You know what I mean? So get at me, man.
Yeah, man. All right. So that's all I got. I am the co-host, Dante.
And I am Galaxy B, DJ Galaxy B, DRB, 3PO, all that stuff, the Babe Jedi. You know what's up.
Perfect. All right, y'all. Well, take it easy, have a good one, and enjoy the video. Peace.
Peace.
Oh, get ready for the shoes on.
And you are listening to WDRB Radio, spinning the most intergalactic hits.
Wake up in the morning getting money like it's crazy. Yo, bitch up on my line, she like salute me like the Navy. I be rubbing biscuits and I hit her with the gravy. It's no Stevie Wonder, why these people always pay me.
Wake up in the morning getting money like it's crazy. Yo, bitch up on my line, she like salute me like the Navy. I be rubbing biscuits and I hit her with the Navy.